नमस्कार मुँ दीप्ति रेखा के एस यूट्यूब चैनल जोड़ा कि कादम्बिनी सृष्टि यूट्यूब चैनल जो थे कि गवर्नमेंट स्कूल पाई लॉकडाउन पीरियड में पाठ पढ़ी पार ना जो मैंने स्कूल को जाई पार ना से यूट्यूब चैनल मध्यम पाठ पढ़ी पारे बहुत किसी शिक्षण जिनस ए शिक्षालाभ करें तेणु यही चैनल को से दरकार शेयर करेंगे सब्सक्राइब करेंगे लाइक भी करेंगे आउ ए चैनल माध्यम रे सब कोनी कोनी छुआ माने निश्चित मात्रा रे किछ ना किछ हासिल करि परिबे शिक्षा को नेके थैंक यू सो मच।
नमस्कार दर्शक बंधु मु शंकर मो पाखरे मास्क पिंदिछि आपण माने भी मास्क पिंदंतु घरे रहंतु किंतु कादमिनी सृष्टि केस ये चैनल टू को सब्सक्राइब करंतु लाइक करंतु पाठ पढंतु एमिति गोटे चैनल जोथिरे कि सब प्रकार पाठ पढ़ा होछि जोटा आपण माने स्कूल जाऊथले पाठ पढ़ुले जीवा को पड़ोनि यूट्यूब चैनल मध्यम आपण सबू जिनस पढ़ी पारे घरे बसिकी तो लाइक करूँ शेयर करूँ सब्सक्राइब करूँ केस कादमिनी सृष्टि।
हेलो गाइस वेलकम to our YouTube channel Kadambini Srishti. I am Kadambini. So can you tell me what is the lifeline of a human being? Yes, it is the heart. So without a heart, a man can't exist. So the basic requirement of our human body is the heart. Without heart, no human being can resist in this world. So likewise, in a English sentence, can you tell me what is the lifeline or which one is the heart of a sentence? Or without that, we can't form any sentence. So what is the heart of English sentence? Yes, guess. Yes, the verb. Verb is termed as the heart of a sentence. Verb is known as the heart of a sentence. That means no verb, no sentence. But with only a single verb, we can have a sentence. For example, read. Is not it a complete meaning? That means I am telling you to read. So only read can also be a sentence. Or we can say go. So, can't you understand what I am saying? Is not it complete in itself? Yes, it is also complete in itself. So, these two words also can be known as the sentences. So, here only read can be a sentence. Go, it also can be a sentence. So, this one is the basic requirement of any sentence. If there is verb, there is a sentence. No verb, no sentence. So it is known as the heart of a sentence. Okay. So which one is the heart of a sentence? The verb is the heart of a sentence. So today we will discuss what is a verb and what are its classifications and what are its divisions. So just imagine, can't we divide human being according to different base? For example, so we can divide human being according to gender as male, female, transgender. Again, the second type of classification. We can divide human being according to age. Okay, that is children, youth, then old. Okay, or we can say young and old. We can also divide human being as fat and thin, tall and short. Is not it? So there are so many types of classifications of human being. So here we cannot just compare tall with fat. Tall is compared with short and fat is compared with thin. Okay. So in this way or likewise, let us discuss what is a verb. So I have written its classifications in this board. So what is a verb? So first one is verb is action or any state. So the first type of verbs I have divided, or as it is in English grammar, the verb is divided into two types. So first one is action verb.
Second one is stative verb.
which the subject or the noun is doing something. So I have given the examples. You can see here run, swim, write, eat and sing. So when someone is doing all these activities, then we call these are the verbs of action. Action means we are doing something using our maybe hand, leg or any part of our body. So when we use any part of our body and do some work, that action is termed as the verb. So this is the action type of verb. Next comes to this static verbs, means it shows some situations or the condition of any human being. So this is another type of verb, that is static verb, as I have written like, want, seem, appear, feel. Static verbs, they never take ing form, means we generally never say I am wanting this. We have to say I want it. Okay, so I want is acceptable and correct in grammar in English. And likewise, we never say that I am liking you. We say I like you. Next comes to the second type of classification. This is a major one, widely used, given in most of the grammars and most important for all the high school students. So what is this type of classifications? So in general, verbs are divided into two parts or two types. First one is auxiliary verb, or we can say the helping verbs, and the second one is the main verb, or it's also known as the full verb. Again, these auxiliary verbs are divided into two types. So what is that? One is primary auxiliary and another is known as the modal auxiliary. So primary auxiliary generally known as the be verb, have verb and do verb. So again, under be verb we have is, am, are, was, were, and also be, being, been is there. And in do verb we have does, do and did. And in have verb we have has, have and had. So these are the primary auxiliaries, and that is used to help the main verb. That's why it is known as the helping verb or the primary auxiliary. The second type of primary auxiliary is known as the modal verbs. So what is the work of the modal verbs? Modal verbs expresses the mood of the speaker, or we can say it shows the emotion of the speaker or who is speaking or who is saying the sentence. So what are these modal auxiliaries? Modal auxiliaries are shall, should, will, would, may, might, can, could. Then we have some need, dare and must, ought to, and finally comes to used to. So now again come to the second type of classification, that is auxiliary and main verb. So what are the main verbs? Main verbs are the main work that the subject is doing. So here comes play, study and read. These verbs also are the action verbs and they have a specific meaning. Okay, but these auxiliary verbs, they primary auxiliary verbs, they generally don't have any meaning, and the modal auxiliary, they express the mood of the speaker. So this is all about the second type of classification. The third type of classification is the finite verb and the non-finite verb. So what does it mean? Finite verbs, they generally carry the tense. Then what is the meaning of carries the tense? When we will do a video on tense, then and there I will make it very clear what is tense and how does a verb carry the tense. But for today's convenience, let me tell you, tense gives us two information. So first one is what is the time of the action, and the second one is what is the degree of completeness of this action. So these two informations is given by the finite verb. So finite verb means only one finite verb in a simple sentence, but we can have more than one non-finite verbs because they don't carry the tense. Okay. So this is the only distinction between finite verb and non-finite verb. Finite verb carries the tense, whereas non-finite verbs doesn't carry any tense. It only gives the information in the sentence. Okay. The fourth type of classification of verbs is known as the transitive verb and the intransitive verb. So let us discuss what is the distinction between transitive verb and intransitive. If the action starts from the subject and ends also with the subject, then that is intransitive verb. But if the action needs some other object, then that is known as transitive verb. Transitive verb needs an object. So what type of object? Suppose if I say laugh, so the laugh starts from me and it ends also with me. So here the action doesn't need any other object. So it is intransitive verb. If I say that teach, so what I am doing here? Yes, suppose I am teaching here. So whom do I teach? Yes, to all my viewers. So here teach needs some object, and that object is essential. And though this verb needs that object, so this verb is known as the transitive verb. Okay, so other example I have given, feed or buy or push. Suppose if someone is feeding a dog, then what does that person need to feed a dog? Must be some food he needs. Okay, so that food is another object which is most essential, and that is required by the verb. So that verb is known as the transitive verb. So transitive verb always needs another object with subject and verb. That means the verb, the action is not complete in itself. It has some requirement. Transitive means it requires, intransitive means it doesn't require. Okay, so example of some intransitive verb like dance, jump, or we can say listen, laugh. That means the verbs which are complete in itself. Those verbs are known as the intransitive verb. This is the most confusing type of verb classification. Here most of the students, they just fail to understand what is transitive and what is intransitive. So let me make it very clear. Transitive means needs object. Intransitive means no object requirement. This is our fourth type of classification. Next comes to the last one, or the fifth type of classification. Here verbs are divided into two types. First one is regular verb and another one is irregular verb. So what is a regular verb? Generally all the verb forms, they have different forms of verb. For example, cook. Cook is the present tense and cooked is past, and its past participle is cooked again. So here the past form of the verb and the past participle, these two forms are equal or same, that is cooked. So it is a regular verb. Okay, but in irregular verb, what happens? Suppose for example, go. Go is the present tense, its past form is went, and past participle is gone. Here you see, the past form is went, past participle form is gone. So these two are equal? No, these two are not equal. So that is a irregular verb. Okay, so regular means past form, past participle form equal. Irregular means past form, past participle form are different. This is the distinction between regular verb and irregular verb. Okay, so here we have completed different types of classification of the verb. So again, let me remind from beginning to end. So first one is the verb. Here verbs are divided into two types:
action verb and stative verb.
Second one is auxiliary and main verb. Third one is finite verb, non-finite verb. Fourth one is transitive, intransitive. And the last one is regular and irregular. So if you have any doubt, then you can ask me using the comment box. Hope you have understood what I have said or what I want to say in this video. Keep learning, keep watching, stay safe, stay home, and we will meet soon with a new video, with a new chapter, and with a new hope. We have already made videos on Odia Medium Class 10 English book. So if you want, you can go to the description box. Here I have given all the links and you can watch that.